So what is your stake in all this?
Same as yours. Peace, stability. A land in which all might live side by side, free and equal.
Why not join the Brotherhood, then?
My father was an assassin. Quite good at his job, too, as I understand it. But I hope to have children someday. It's hard to live in two worlds at the same time. So I chose to live in one.
I understand.
I still contribute as I can. That's why we're here now.
What can you tell me of Thomas Hickey?
He has been running a counterfeiting ring in the city. Locate the source of his operation, and we can have him arrested. He cannot harm the commander if he is in prison.
Do you know where he is?
Not exactly, but I have an idea where we can begin the search.
Whoa.
Rumors of bad bills being circulated here. No doubt they come from Thomas.
I think it has to do with the beetle. The little one that eats the wood. You should see that.
What are you up to? This isn't money. It's colored paper. You've cheated me for the last time. God!
guards done to us.
How? What happened?
Dan Shopkeep called me out. Brought the guards, but I gave him the slip.
Boss is gonna be mad.
Not so mad as if I'd got the court. Besides, we've got most everything we need for the job now anyway.
Best go tell him. I'll warn the others.
Josiah's cudgels warn them off. Tenacious.
Spot of trouble since I slipped away. Of course, I'm taking care to keep the distance.
I believe we're really gonna do this.
We'll be heroes. The ones who ended all this talk of revolution. They'll set us up like kings, then. Revolution. Bunch of troublemakers looking to upset the apple cart. And some fool filled their heads with rubbish, ruining it for the rest of us good folk.
Good folk? Really?
Of course. You and me and Hickey. Just some hard luck lads trying to survive in this cold, cruel world.
The New York Chronicle! Buy a gear
for the better trouble.
Is your gut never get tired of all that flack?
Move it! Let me
wait! By heaven, did you think I did?
Settle down. There's no need for being ornery here, now is there?
You better
there will be a presentation of the latest sacred coral.
I've had about enough of
the innovation proposals. Let's support this coming Saturday. Come see the new summer designs at Miss Bracknell. Daring bodice cuffs and lighter petticoats to keep you roses from wilting.
They are preceded by a scrawny little petty barber.
Come and get today's New York Chronicle!
He's as bent as a big one.
Christ, is there something on this miserable
carpet?
Thank you.
needs, come to Captain Hornbill's. Whether a fleet or a weekend angler, he's got everything to make a jump off the water.
What's this? Thomas Hickey? Might be. What's it to you? Ain't supposed to be none of your kind left. Suppose I'd best be rectifying that then. Get him! Be still. You will do no more harm.
You're a right fool meddling in affairs you know nothing about.
Washington's the only thing keeping the Continental Army together. You kill him, you end all hope for freedom.
Wrong, boyo. With him gone, they'll have no choice but to promote Lee, and then...
You are both under arrest!
Oh, well, we were just having a scrap, officer. Ain't nothing wrong with two men settling their differences the old-fashioned way. Can't we come to a...
Quiet!
What are the charges?
Counterfeiting!
I had nothing to do with that.
Course not!
Listen, there are more important things at stake here. This man is planning to...
You missed me, sweetheart. What? Nothing to say?
If you are here, then Washington is safe.
True, true. Thing is, I believe I've just been pardoned. Thank you kindly for the rescue, gents.
There can be no further mistakes, Thomas. Am I understood?
What about the assassin? Yeah. He's here. They put him in a cell right next to mine. Guess we didn't get them all, eh?
Deal with this, Charles.
At once, sir.
What are we gonna do?
You're that boy from the Continental Congress. Adams's little lapdog. I think I have an idea. Yes. Two birds with one stone.
Do tell.
All in good time. It's not like the assassin's going anywhere. For now, we should see about getting you better accommodations here.
What are you on about? I thought I was getting out.
I'm afraid you won't be leaving for a while, thanks to Benjamin Talmadge. He's been running his mouth, saying all sorts of things. You're being investigated for plotting to assassinate George Washington.
What a bunch of bollocks! I thought you was gonna handle that!
We'll discuss this elsewhere.
Should get in on it.
Yeah? And what makes you think that?
Caught him carving something in the yard. Slipped it in his pocket real quick when he saw me. Looked like a key.
Probably just a shiv.
Nah. Mason ain't a fighter. Always talking and tricking his way out of trouble. Weasel Weems, they call him. Stinky bastard.
Come on, Finch. He's not so bad. Even told me some letters once. Gonna write a note to my lady.
Ha! What for? You think that whore's out there pining for you? Saving herself for when you get out? Huh? No doubt she's already moved on to the next fella, and the fella after him.
You shut your mouth before I shut it for you.
Easy now. Was just a joke.
Yeah? Well, it wasn't very funny.
Going.
Stay out of trouble or you'll wind up in the pit.
Late last night. I'm feeling a little bit difficult to type. But tomorrow, yeah. Then I will try. A long journey. Not sure that.
What are you looking at, half-breed?
I'll raise the wire.
You not understand English? That it? Do I need to knock some sense into that thick head of yours?
He won't come. His wife's gone into labor. Last I saw him, he was running in circles, built with staring eyes and an idiot grin across his face.
I should try and find this Weems fellow. If he intends to escape, perhaps he can help me.
No, thanks. I was in my schnitz until quite late last night. I am feeling a little bit difficult to take. But from what?
Please don't hurt me!
There's truth in what you say,
but we also have a choir supplemented by some of the garrison officers.
How's Broadwell treating you, lad? Not too rough, I hope.
Some are too strong, but willing to favor us, you meet ruin.
contain your exuberance. Have a care, sir. I might have been injured. We do hope that will be
soon. Just go away!
Mason Weems?
Could be.
I need your help.
Oh?
They say you know a way out of here.
They say a lot of things.
I do not have time for games.
Shame, as I was hoping you might play one with me.
Fine.
Are you familiar with the rules? Seeing as you already know mine, what's your name?
Connor.
Pleased to meet you, Connor. Well played. So, what brings you to Bridewell?
Treachery. I have been falsely accused.
Of course you have.
Yes, we did. You do not believe me?
Why should I? You have the look of a brute.
You misjudge. I'm an honest man.
He must finish his business for the major. And yet, also a man imprisoned. Tell me how you found yourself in this place.
It is a private matter.
As is what you ask of me.
Really? No, his sister. Really? Then why do tell? She seems a thoroughly sensible creature. Does not like to party.
I was trying to prevent a murder.
Oh. Anyone I know?
George Washington.
The others put you up to this, didn't they? Thought it might be fun to have another laugh at Mason's expense. Fools, a lot of them. To make light of something like this. George Washington is brave beyond measure. Loyal like a brother, peerless in character, and unshakable in his convictions. That man is our Jupiter Conservator. Destined to lead us not just to freedom, but greatness. Anyone who says otherwise is either a simpleton or a traitor.
Then you understand why I need to get out of here. If I don't help him, he is going to die.
I've always room for another pair of strong arms.
You're serious, aren't you?
Ah, but you see, it is important, not how you do it.
Very well. But it's going to take some doing. See, everything hinges on the key I forged. But that lout Finch stole it. Took me 3 months to make the thing, too. You need to get it back, or we're not going anywhere.
Consider it done.
I have another Garrick well underway.
The medley of lords.
So soon as the strike stops, we'll be rushing to get up on Tuesday.
He would take the forest mushrooms and drops them in a big pottery jar. Then Opa would pour in his special jar.
Your cells!
It is important not how you do it.
key is useless.
A little farm by the Salisbury Plains.
What are you looking at? You in the market for Osbin?
Your key is useless.
What do you mean?
It did not fit the lock.
It's not meant to.
You forged a key that does not work.
Well, that all depends on what you mean by work. It'll get us out of here. Just not the way you expected.
Then how?
You're going to use it to get the real key off the warden. You have to swap yours for his.
Why not just have me take the real key? Why all this extra work?
He might notice if it went missing. This way, he'll be none the wiser.
And when he tries to use it?
He won't. That's why we're targeting him.
How do I reach the warden?
Yes. This next part, you may not like.
Oh, as if I've liked the others. Out with it.
You need to pick a fight.
What?
Pick a fight, and they'll throw you in the pit.
And how in the world does this help us?
The warden oversees the pit. Getting sent there is the only way to reach him.
I give you credit. You've given this plan to risk my life a great deal of thought.
Take down as many as you can. One or two will only serve to entertain the guards. You need to make them angry. We all have our part to play. Try not to die.
Yeah.
out for trouble, eh? Some time in the pits to cool your blood.
Show them the pain.
Look at all of you, pathetic, dirty wretches. You're not but swine, suckling at the teats of civilization. Thieves and scoundrels all. And do you acknowledge this? Do you repent and beg forgiveness? No. You elect instead to commit new and more terrible...
Need to take care not to raise the alarm.
You'll find Hickey through that door. It's where they keep the important prisoners. Nicer rooms, more space, those sorts of things. It seems even in prison, who you know makes all the difference.
Thank you, Mason, for everything. I will find a way to repay the favor when my work here is finished.
Not who you was expecting, am I right?
What have we here? I thought we'd finished off your kind.
You would like that, wouldn't you? To rid the world of all who do not share your views.
Guilty as charged. Your meddling in the revolution has caused us no small measure of grief. It cannot continue. Our work is too important. But what would you know beyond all the lies Achilles feeds you and the tales you tell yourself?
I know that the people wish to be free, and that men like Washington fight to make it so.
Please, the man is weak. He stumbles and stammers through each engagement, making it all up as he goes along. His pedigree is pathetic, his military record even more so. I could go on and on, but we'd be here for days, so manifold are his faults, so deficient are his merits. He must be dealt with. You as well. I will abide no more flies in the ointment.
Here's how it's gonna work. First we bind you and bring you to your cell. Then tomorrow, you go before the court, accused of plotting to kill good old Georgie. Maybe we could pin the murder of the warden on you too. You did kill him after all. And who wouldn't take the word of Charlie over here? Once that's all squared away, well then.
All those years ago, the child in the forest was you.
I said I would find you.
And so you have. But not quite as you had expected, am I right? You know, all of this might have been avoided had you only done what I asked. Ah, but what's done is done.
up with you! I said, get up! Walk!
Bye now!
Hello, Connor. Didn't think I'd miss your going away party, did ya? I hear Washington himself is gonna be in attendance. Hope nothing bad happens to him.
You said there'd be a trial.
Oh, no trial for traitors, I'm afraid. Lee and Hafham sorted that. It's straight to the gallows for you.
I will not die today. The same cannot be said for you.
That's enough! Get moving!
When you need us.
Forget about me. You need to stop Hickey. He's...
Up you go. Don't want to be late now, do we? You just had to be an hero, didn't you? You and Georgie both. Now you see what it gets you. A pine box, little else.
Brothers, sisters, fellow patriots, several days ago we learned of a scheme so vile, so dastardly, that even repeating it now disturbs my being. The man before you plotted to murder our much beloved general. Indeed, what darkness or madness moved him, none can say, and he himself offers no defense, shows no remorse. And though we have begged and pleaded with him to share what he knows, he maintains a deadly silence. If the man will not explain himself, if he will not confess and atone, what other option do we have but this? He sought to send us into the arms of the enemy. And thus we are compelled by justice to send him from this world. May God have mercy on your soul.
Need to stop, Hickey. Go!
Damn it. I thought I'd at least live to see another day. Shame.
I want answers. Why did Johnson try and buy my people's land? Why was Pitcairn targeting Adams and Hancock? What purpose would Washington's murder have served? Why does your order support the British?
How should I know? The Templars, Lee, the big man, Hafham. They has the money. They has the power. That's the reason I threw him with them. That's the only reason. Sure, they have some sort of vision for the future, too. I didn't give a damn about any of that. They can sing their songs about mankind and its troubles. They can make their plans and spring their traps. Don't bother me none. They paid me, so I said yes. Didn't bother to ask who. Or how, or why. Didn't care.
You chose to side with men who would rob us of our humanity simply because it was more profitable?
What else is there? I'm not some blind fool to give up all I've got on principle. What is principle anyway? Can you bring it to the bank? Don't look at me like that. We're different, you and I. You're just some blind fool who's always chasing butterflies, whereas I'm the type of guy who likes to have a beer in one hand and a tea in the other. Thing is, boy, I can have what I seek, had it even. You, your hands will always be empty.
I said, lower your goddamn guns! This man's a hero! Oh, the general can be so stubborn sometimes. Piffle, he said, when we warned him something like this would happen. Piffle!
Stop!
He wanted to kill the commander. Nearly killed you as well. He was a scoundrel.
But still a man.
You're nothing if not consistent.
Where is Washington? I need to speak with him.
Bundled off as soon as your execution went sideways. He's likely on his way back to Philadelphia by now.
And so am I.
Something wrong?
He is still in danger. Hickey did not act alone.
Quite impressive what you've accomplished.
Is that a compliment?
Well, don't misconstrue. I'm sure the whole endeavor will end tragically. But to have come this far, well, it's more than I ever expected.
The people yearned for freedom but feared to grab hold of it. That fear is gone now.
Thanks to you?
No. This they did on their own.
You diminish your role, but you have always been of humble heart.
I do what is right.
No more, no less.
You cannot tell him.
I have to. Otherwise, he will never be safe.
He is safer not knowing. By planting the seeds of doubt, you threaten to topple his entire endeavor. If Washington is paralyzed, Charles Lee will strike. You'll cause the very thing you aim to prevent. Hunt the Templars, as is your duty. But do not drag these men in. To it.
And for the support of this declaration.
We must now all hang together.
Yes, we must indeed all hang together. Or most assuredly, we shall all hang separately.
You are once more our savior.
I must speak with the commander.
He's gone to try and hold New York. The British intend to take it. I fear we'll need to recall our men from Quebec as well. It's one thing to declare our independence. Now, my friend, we must make it so.
Everything all right?
Sean has located a second power source. I've asked Rebecca to charter a flight for us.
Where to?
Brazil.
Rebecca?
Bad reception. Can you hear me?
Well, glad to see that's working. Guess I'll try you back when I'm topside.
Pinpointing her location, but she's most likely inside a VIP booth on the stadium's upper level. I'll update you when I know more.
Now to find a ticket.
We don't have time to play nice. Steal someone else's.
Certo.
Bit of a dick move, don't you think?
Well, I guess you could try and sneak past security instead.
That doesn't look like normal security.
Because it isn't. Those are Abstergo agents. Cross is probably here too. You need to be careful.
That doesn't look like normal security.
Because it isn't. Those are Abstergo agents. Cross is probably here too. You need to be careful. Your target's definitely in the VIP area. The entrance is at the end of this concourse.
Chame a segurança imediatamente, Sylvie.
Don't let them see you.
Great. You've set up a checkpoint. Seriously, what is the deal with stadiums and piss troughs? It's disgusting. And who thought they were a good idea?
Troughs are time and cost efficient.
I don't even see a stall in here. What if I have to take a dump?
Yeah, please just mute the microphone if you do.
Looks like I'm close. Shit! Another checkpoint.
You're gonna have to find another way around. Security's too tight here.
Como assim? Trabalho aqui há 15 anos e nunca vi nada como isso. Quem vocês pensam que são?
Sugiro abaixar o tom de voz.
Ah, está bem. Faça a porcaria da verificação. Que bando de ratinho! Passam 20 minutos simulando ser fanão e fatura milhões. Eu quebro as costas trabalhando 80 horas por semana para tirar 100 pratos.
Estou com fome.
Olha, aconteceu só isso. A gente não queria que acontecesse. Só aconteceu. Sinto muito.
Sente muito? Ela é minha irmã, cara! A porra da minha irmãzinha!
A gente se ama. Pronto, tá aí, tá dito. A gente se ama e já faz muito tempo.
Almost there, Desmond. She's just on the other side of the stadium.
Other side?
Other side of the stadium.
Other side? Other side?
Don't let them see you. Almost there, Desmond. She's just on the other side of the stadium.
Other side?
away with the artifact, we're screwed. You can't let that happen.
Aquele cara
tá maluco.
We can get back to Connor whenever you're ready, Desmond. Unless you want to plug in the power source first. Up to you.
I can't believe it's taken me so long to ask, but... how's Mom? She's not...
No. Your mother is fine. We decided it was safer if we split up for this job.
Always assuming the worst.
For good reason.
Can I at least say hi to her?
I'm sorry, it's too risky. Maybe when we're done.
Right. When we're done.
So, what's the latest? Learn anything interesting while you were exploring?
They were working on some weird stuff towards the end. Trying to engineer new bodies and store their minds inside computers.
Failure after failure. It must have been hard for them.
It worry about it too. I mean, they say there's something in here that'll help us. But what is it? Why is it locked up if it's exactly what we need?
I don't know. Maybe it's dangerous. Maybe they wanted to make sure only you could reach it.
That's the other question. What makes me so special?
I guess we'll know once we open the door.
Unbelievable.
What's up?
Your politicians are constantly referencing the Founding Fathers and insisting they must have been in support of one thing or another. I have never seen such a blatant disregard for history.
That's just typical political propaganda.
It's also dishonest and delusional. How can anyone claim to know what these people wanted based off scraps of paper and wishful thinking?
They're looking for intent. What these men envision for our country and its future.
Idealistic. And unlikely. I don't think most of your presidents and senators and judges care what the Founders thought. They just want to know how they can bend old words to achieve modern goals. Who cares if they were deists or theists or wanted a central bank? Why do people need the validation? What should matter is what you, as an individual, believe and why you believe it. What, are we so insecure that we have to find 18th century letters to validate our beliefs? Oh, look, Mum, a dead man agreed with me. Maybe. If you transpose the letters in his shopping list, you can plainly see he was on my side.
Jesus, Sean. That's a cynical way to look at it.
Doesn't make it less true.